What a night of boxing it's been at the Lakeland Center here. PBC, the next round on Bounce TV. And we're set for our main event. Time now to take a look at the Little Caesars tale of the tape. And it's Kanat Islam going up against Juan De Angel. So De Angel, 1 year younger, both fighters at 5'10". Look at the reach advantage for De Angel. And both fighters making the 155-pound weight limit. Let's send it over now to Ray Flores for the official introductions.
From Lakeland Center here in Lakeland, Florida, Premier Boxing Champions now features the main event. Live on Bounce, 10 rounds in the super welterweight division. The three judges ringside are Brian Gary, Alex Levin, and Michael Ross. And the referee in charge when the bell sounds, Telis Assimenios. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the blue with the white. His professional record, 18 wins, 3 losses, 1 draw, including 17 wins by KO. Hailing from Barranquilla, Colombia. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Juan La Amenaza de Angel. And across the ring, his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the baby blue with the white trim, as a professional, perfect 20 wins, 17 of those coming by way of knockouts. Fighting out of Bohoki, Florida, by way of Almaty, Kazakhstan. A 2-time Olympian who won a bronze medalist in the games in Beijing. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting Kanat, the Kazakh Islam.
Gentlemen, you have received instructions to the dressing rooms. Obey my commands at all times. Protect yourselves at all times. Shake hands, good luck, and God bless.
We are ready for 10 rounds of action here in the super welterweight division. And we are pleased to be joined once again ringside by Erickson, the Hammer Lubin. And this is Erickson's division as well. Erickson 14-0. We've got Kanat Islam here, who is at 20-0 and 17. KOs and Juan De Angel, 18-3-2 with 17 KOs. Grant Charles, Steve Cunningham, Barry Hunter with you from Lakeland Center in Lakeland, Florida. And here we go. First of a scheduled 10 rounder. K-Slam there in the light blue trunks. And De Angel in the royal blue.
K-Slam immediately came out, two jabs to the midsection of De Angel. Another one there. He's trying to take the steam, take the power, setting up for that overhand.
De Angel needed a punch here, though, with that quick jab that caught Islam right on the chin.
Erickson, you've been in there with Islam. What kind of inside information can you give?
He's very strong. He's a very strong fighter, and he puts his punches together. It was a very strong match as well.
And you can tell there, just from looking at this one, you can tell. He's thick for 155 pounds.
He looks more like a junior middleweight.
Nice jab there to the body from De Angel.
De Angel isn't a small guy.
No, he's not. Nice 1-2 there from De Angel. He does it again.
Good body grip by K-Slam. Continues to go back to the body. Very intelligent.
And he catches De Angel. Nice overhand right. And there's the power we were talking about.
De Angel came back with a good two-punch combination there. Back K-Slam off.
Stop! Don't punch! Break! Break!
It's So those body shots are gonna, if this fight goes rounds, they're gonna show up in the next few rounds, and we may see some steam taken off of those shots by Deion.
So you like what Islam is doing here with the jabs and the body shots,
which is one of the keys to victory you spoke about earlier.
And if you see, if you notice, Islam goes down, K-Slam goes down, it goes down, then he comes up. He's changing the levels, you know, basically up and down, giving his opponent something different to look at second guess.
Good right, good left hook by Deion Miller.
Good stuff here in the first round with Islam and Deion on hell. And Kanat Islam, as we get to know him just a little bit more here.
Cool.
And this guy, Barry mentioned it, fought for China in both 04 and 08, won a bronze medal in 08.
And he works the captain. He worked in the jab and work off the jab. Don't throw the right hand by itself.
12 times for them as well.
First throw the jab. Get close to him. You should feed to get close to him.
And was 8-4. Touch him with the jab. Touch him with the jab. But the Kazakhstan did very well in the World Series of Boxing. And there's a big right hand there.
Well, Fran, you remember I said earlier, use the jab. And the jab could open up something possibly over top, big right hand or big left hook, which he can do both. And I'm looking at something familiar in this corner. He's not taking a stool.
Well, what do you think about that?
Well, you know, when you're in the gym and fight a spa all the time, 10, 12, sometimes 14, 15 rounds, he never sat down.
Okay. All right.
Seconds out. Let's go.
So it all depends on the individual. I don't have a problem with it.
Well, that's old school. That's how they do it in Headbangers there in D.C. But I don't know, Bear. Steve, do they do that? Did they do that in Philly with you?
Yeah, same thing.
Okay,
man.
All right.
Spar, they ain't no sitting down in the gym. Okay. That's the rule anyway. You don't sit down in the gym, period.
Okay. I like it. So Kanat Islam is showing you that he's definitely stooped to the game here. Also looked like he was breathing was remarkable, too. Round two of the schedule, 10 rounds. Nice right hand there. Deion Hell misses with his right.
He missed with that right hand because he telegraphed it. That was one out of anger.
Okay.
I got to get my punch back.
Okay. And those shots, those anger shots, take a lot of energy out of you when you miss.
Yes, they do.
And this guy, K-Slam, he's taking energy from him by touching him to the body, continuing, even little taps. And you see, Deion Hell, he's going full force with every shot.
Erickson, if you are Kanat Islam here, what would your plan of attack be against Deion Hell?
I mean, he's doing what he has to do. He's boxing him and picking the right shots. He's baiting Deion Hell into some big shots, and I think he's going well.
Double jab there from Deion Hell.
You're going to see Islam starting to touch him to the body. And he's really trying to set something up over top.
Nice short, crisp right hand there from Islam. Starting to see already a small welt under the left eye. Deion Hell. Scraping left hook that time from Islam. Bit of a herky jerky motion here from Steve.
Yeah, you know, they're both keeping their legs alive, man. You know, especially K-Slam, because he's basically dictating the pace. He's fighting when he wants to fight, and he's making Deion Hell do what he wants him to do. Pulling the matador to an extent.
Straight left hand snaps back ahead of Deion Hell. And there's the overhand right that seems to Barry been the one punch that lands with consistency here.
And he keeps landing this punch over and over again. Me and Steve, we always speak about the change up, the switch up. I think he'll do justice by going to the body a little bit more and then open up that right hand a little bit more over the top.
It's a good jab that time by Deion Hell. As both fighters exchange right hands.
You know, I got a question for Steve and Erickson. Both of you guys for international competition. That style that Islam has is a little very familiar, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. It really does.
Right! Don't punch!
I took two rounds in the books here, and Juan, Deion Hell, 18-3-2, with 17 knockouts. Debuted back in 2008, been a pro for close to 8 years, born and raised in Colombia. This is his first career fight in the United States, and you saw Juan Marquez as his idol here. And you can see that precision fighter, Marquez, technical guy. And we see that from Deon Hell likes the 1-2, tries to set it up a little bit. What makes Marquez so special is that just when you think this guy's hurt, you got him. And then you could be in trouble yourself.
Yeah, Marquez was one of the greatest fighters of our time.
Yes, he was.
He's a surgical fighter.
Yep.
And he don't waste no punches, he don't waste no movement, but you will know. You will know you in there with Marquez after the first round.
Seconds out.
Islam has never been down as a pro here. Deon Hell was down just once as a pro. But it was an interesting story here. He lost by knockout fashion to Alberto Ramirez. Ramirez is now a belt holder, championship belt holder at 168 pounds, but they fought not. And they fought at 168 pounds back then, and that was the first and only time that Deon Hell's ever fought at 168 pounds. Took the fight there on short notice, 20 days. And he said, told us in the meeting, that let him know at that time, now that he had seen Ramirez ascend to the heights that he's ascended to, I can do this. I can do this at a really high level. That's only time he's been knocked down. Islam has never been knocked down as a pro.
A lot of times, friend, a loss isn't always a bad thing if you can learn from it. You have a lot of ex-world champions, Hall of Famers that have lost a fight early on in their career, and right now they're etched in the minds of everybody that's a fan of boxing.
No doubt. No doubt.
Ray Leonard, Thomas Hearn, Marvin Hagler, Sugar Ray Robinson. I need to say no more.
They've all got L's. Only a couple who don't. And one that we're very familiar with in this generation is Floyd Mayweather.
And then Ricardo Lopez.
That's one, too. Yep.
That's the one.
Never lost a fight in the amateurs or pro. At worst, he got his brother.
That's bad.
It's round three of a scheduled 10 rounder here.
K-Slam is finding a home for that right here every time. He's very calculated about it, and he's very sparingly when he uses it. But when he uses it, it's money.
Erickson, we've been able to see you a couple of times, and you like to take care of business as quickly as possible.
Yes, sir.
But you see Islam being patient here is... When you see him sparring in the gym, is that something that you recognize, the patience?
I haven't really seen too much in the gym, but as I can see right now, he's taking his time. He's real patient, using his jab, breaking him down to the body a lot. I feel like in the later rounds, he might be able to get him out.
Is it frustrating for you as a young fighter when you can't go in and wreck shop? I mean, right away, because like I said, when you get someone hurt, usually it's a wrap pretty quickly.
Yeah, yeah. I really like to get them out quick, but if they don't go, you know, I like to break them down and eventually try to get them out.
That's a nice one, too, from Deon Hell. So Deon Hell proving his game. All right, three rounds in the books here. And Steve, you called that you saw this early and you continue to see it. This right hand that basically Islam can throw and land pretty much whatever he wants.
Well, you see, Islam, he's rocking back. He's waiting for Deon Hell to throw a jab. He's setting him up by jabbing downstairs and then just launching that right hand. But right here, he just launches it and it found a home.
Steve, for the viewers at home, can you go back to rocking back on the right hand and pretty much break that down?
Keep touching, okay?
Well, when your opponent throws a jab at you, you can take that little step back, and it opens the gap for you to just come in with an even faster, straight, sharp, clean right hand that will hit you wide open.
And, you know, and that's a beautiful shot. It's a beautiful shot, and it can be a dangerous shot, especially if you turn the shoulder with your hands down, because you can get hit with a counter.
I mean, we see it all the time with Floyd Mayweather. That's one of his favorite shots.
Right.
This is a fight that's been on Deion L's radar here for quite some time. And Steve, this is something you touched upon here. Deion L here has three fighters, three touches, two fighters. We'll get to that story momentarily, but we want to take a look down to scoring rounds. Brought to you by Little Caesars with a PBC historian, Jake Donovan. Jake, how do you have it through three?
Kanat Islam up 40-27. With everything that Coach Barry Hunter suggested, showing the whole arsenal, he's being a lot more patient than he has been in the past. We used to throw a lot of punches. He's landed that right hand with consistency. Dan Hell is landing a little bit, just not enough. 30-27 through three.
Sounds good, Jake.
I agree with Jake's scorecard. Dead on.
Getting back to Deion Hell, this fight kind of being on his radar here. He's got three cousins who fight, and one of them is Fidel Monterosa. And you mentioned it, Monterosa, he met Kanat Islam in Colombia, a five-round knockout back in 2014. And Deion Hell, he was there in the crowd live. He saw him fight twice live, and so he said, okay, this is a guy, 154 pounds. I might get in the ring with down the road. It's always kind of been in the back of his mind to get an opportunity.
Chop!
Family business. And he has that chance right now.
Sometimes he can be a good motivator, and sometimes he can get you in some serious trouble. Most of the time, right there. You normally don't want to come into a fight emotional like that, with revenge on your mind. I'm going to get him because he got this. But you want to be composed, relaxed, and just calm.
Dan Hell started to be conscious of the right hand coming over the top. He started to make somewhat of a little adjustment to it.
Just in case Slime switched to softball position.
Sure did.
Yeah, good left hook.
A hold.
I want to let you know here, we're going to commercial free the rest of the way. And that's brought to you by Firehouse Subs, the hero of all subs. So hang with us. Get rid of the remote just to sit back and enjoy.
Yeah, K-Slam's having fun.
Stop.
Switching southpaw, doing different shots. Just like Barry said,
King of Kong.
Telis Assimenios.
Hey, this way.
Calling time as Islam connected low there with Deion Hell. So you get up to 5 minutes if you want him here.
I'm surprised, Steve, that more fighters don't take the full 5 minutes.
What do you think, though? First off, is it low?
It's on the bell, you know. Right there, yeah. Kind of, sort of.
And then those cups, man, the way they...
And they ride up.
Yeah, exactly. So you can hit the cup high and it's still...
That's low.
Yeah, it's still...
That's right on the name.
Once again, that's 5 minutes.
It's a man.
Yeah, it's a man. They had to fight at the end. Look, I'm here to fight. I ain't here to take a break. And you see K-Slam going down, and then I was just about to say he's going to come back up. It's going to be a fake. Sitting downstairs and I'm seeing
it. See what? He's going to turn it up there a little bit. The end of the fourth round.
Time!
All right, Barry. Take us back to round
four. You can see here the adjustment Dan Hale has made to the right-hand counters. He's going to roll the shoulders.
Yep, right there.
Took it away from him. So if you're Islam or Islam's corner, you want to make an adjustment to the adjustment. Start going to the body a little bit more. Close the gap.
If you go to the body a little bit more, what exactly will that do?
What it'll do, it'll take his mind off that counter right hand. It'll drop his hands to defend the body. And now you can go back upstairs and throw them big bombs upstairs once again.
Yeah, it's a chess match. It's out here as we start the fifth of a scheduled 10 rounders.
Hey, Hill comes out with a jab, a good jab, by the
way. All right, Erickson, here we go here. Now, you sparred with Kanat Islam, so what is he doing that you haven't seen before?
Our sparring session only lasted a round, so... I haven't seen too much of him. He's doing a lot of things. He has good movement with his feet and good head movement.
So it only lasted a round. Did that mean it was hammer time?
It was hammer time.
Don't hurt him. Don't hurt him, man. That's a nickname that we call Erickson,
right.
Which is a terrific young fighter, and I'm almost 100% positive. Let me change that. I am 100% positive that one day somebody's gonna put a world title around me.
Okay.
Wait.
Thank you, Terry.
I remember when I first moved to Pittsburgh and the Hammer was fighting the some fights up there.
Chop! Don't punch! Right.
I was very impressed.
Thank you.
See those little taps to the body?
Yes, sir.
Even those little taps means significant damage. You know, just a little tap. You're taking the wind from a guy, and the opponent who's getting hit doesn't even know. We're used to something being big, but those little taps, they mean something. Very, very intelligent, educated fighter here in K-Slam.
Okay, Frank, you see the adjustment that I'm talking about as far as Islam is concerned. He started walking down a little bit more.
Okay.
Take his game into the inside a little bit.
Hey, nice work here by Dayon Hill.
A lot of the steam Dayon Hill threw punches he threw just now. Islam took the power off of him by rolling the shoulder.
Okay.
And now, Dayon Hill, his power isn't what it was in round one. He's only round five. Touching to the body that took that into a good body shot.
That's right. Good power punches. Good work to the body from Kanat Islam. And that certainly takes its toll.
He's launching that right hand. He's trying to get down the lot of that right hand.
The right hand is not there right now. He needs to concentrate on the body. He's doing a good job by putting him on his heel. But
big right hand. He's figuring out how to get back to it, no doubt. Dayon Hill couldn't get away from that one. And Islam is trying to go to work here as we close out the fifth round. Good stuff here to close out the fifth round of Islam and Dayon Hill. Let's show you here as we come to the close. Let's show you the upcoming Premier Boxing Champions fights coming up here. Good one on Showtime. Aris Landy Lahr will go up against Manas Monterosian. And also, you're going to see our Austin Trout on that card as well. Go up against Jamal Charlo and Jermel, the twin brother, on the card as well. Big one on CBS, June 25th. One time against Showtime. Keith Thurman going up against Sean Porter. The welterweight to class as well. You did not see Erickson Lubin's name on that graphic, but he will be fighting on NBC on June 18th. How do you feel, young man? You ready?
I feel great. You know, I'm starting camp. You know, I'm getting the best shape of my life and, you know, plan to perform.
Where are you right now, Erickson, do you think, in your development here? 14-0, or do you feel like you're moving at the right pace?
I'm moving at the right pace. You know, if it was up to me, I'll fight anyone on any day. But, you know, I have a management team that wants me to develop more into a fighter.
Well, I will say this. I mean, when you look at the opponents who Erickson Lubin has gotten the ring with, you don't see a lot of lopsided records. You see guys who have experience, and you see guys who have substantial winning records. And Erickson, I know that's been by design, which has helped you gain a lot of experience in a short amount of time.
Yes, sir.
Erickson has a great manager and a very good friend of mine in Henry in Baltimore. And also Gary Jonas. These are good guys. I think they've done a terrific job with moving Erickson along in this fight game.
Yes, sir.
You get an opportunity to see Erickson do his thing June 18th on NBC, PBC, across many platforms.
No hope, no hope.
We are bringing boxing back to you. This one here is the second time he has passed the fifth round. And the only other occasion is fight with the scorecard. If you look at this one throughout his career, I mean, the first eight fights he had happened in 11 weeks. Then he had a three-month break. Then he had five more fights in a seven-week stretch. Now, we're in a situation here. He's fought seven times in the past 3 years, but he said he had to get that work in early because the fights were ending.
Stop, stop,
and
stop.
One, two, three rounds, and he felt he did all this training, Steve, and he wasn't really getting the benefit because he wasn't going for very long distances. So he kept racking up fights.
Yeah, I mean, you know, sometimes you have fighters like that that just win the game and that just won't fight.
Looks like that he might have an issue here with
five,
with his
six,
ankle, and
seven. Hey, are you okay?
Assimenios,
are you okay?
Had a knockdown.
Are you okay?
And it looks like there's an ankle issue, his left ankle. And here comes Kanat.
Down
takes a knee there again.
Four.
And that's going to be it. Telis Assimenios is going to call off the action here in the sixth round as Deion Hell with some ankle issues in the middle of a round, and it looks like he cannot continue.
Yeah.
And there you see him say, hurt his right ankle, as they're going to take a peek at it right now. But here we go, Barry. Got hit with a left hand right there. It looked like when he was stepping back, we can see. Looking for the ankle tweak.
I didn't see the tweak myself. You know, I don't know if Islam hit that hard.
Might get a better angle from here because it's up top. So let's take another look. As he backs up.
Maybe while he was backing up, he stepped down on the wrong. That could happen also.
But went down immediately there, you saw. And he is grabbing his right ankle. And tried to give it a go, but he could not. So Kanat Islam is going to improve to 21-0 with 18 knockouts. And there you see, they're trying to get Deion Hell here out of the ring. And just give them a little bit more space so they can take a look at the ankle. Islam, meanwhile, has done it again. So now here's Ray Flores with the official decision brought to you by Firehouse Subs.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 22 seconds of the sixth round. Juan de Angel unable to continue for your winner by technical knockout. And remaining undefeated, Kanat, the Kazakh Islam.